Hi, I'm Mary Ellen, and welcome to Video Wednesday, when the Southport Historical Society showcases one of our vintage historical markers. These markers were replaced many years ago and were put in storage. We've cleaned them up and we'll be auctioning them online beginning 31 May through June 24th. Join us on our Facebook page every Wednesday until then and enjoy our videos of these vintage historical markers. Our vintage historical marker today highlights the old jail. Prior to 1904, the jail in Southport was described as a wooden building which was old and dilapidated. Obviously, it needed to be replaced. A two-story brick building was needed. It was February of 1904 when the ground was broken for what was known at that time as the new jail. The lowest bid was received for $6,738. The jailer and his family had living quarters on the first floor. The top floor, which was used for prisoners, contained cells and a washroom. This facility was used until 1978 when the county seat was moved from Southport to Bolivia. Our presenter today needs no introduction, but it is my pleasure to do so. Southport Police Chief Todd Coring has been in law enforcement for 25 years. Serving with the Brunswick County Sheriff's Department, and now his fifth year of dedicated duty to the citizens of Southport as our police chief. Todd is no stranger to volunteerism, as he has served on the Southport Fire Department since 1991, and now with the responsibility as assistant fire chief. Todd has served on the Southport Board of Aldermen, and during that time, he acted as mayor pro tem. Chief Coring is true to his family's career choices and is a third generation Southport police chief. To listen to his presentation, let's join him at the old jail. Chief Todd Coring.
Hello, my name is Todd Coring. I'm the police chief of the city of Southport, and I'm honored to stand here in our historic jail here in Southport and talk to you today a little bit about the history. I'm a third generation police chief here in Southport. My grandfather served 9 years or three terms then as the police chief, and then my father also served 12 years here in Southport. So I'm honored to be here today on behalf of the Historic Society to tell you a little bit about our jail and some of the interesting things. Growing up here in Southport, I recall many times coming by here and looking at the jail. I don't recall as a child stories. Of course, that was before my time, but being able to talk to my grandfather and some of the folks I know that served as jailers here in this jail at the time, it's quite interesting that some of the things that happened here with the jail. Southport's a small community, so if you're in the area, I would encourage you to stop by and take a look behind me. You'll see some of the artifacts that they've collected of the many police chiefs that we've had throughout the years. So we're just really proud of our history here in Southport. So if you take a look here at the jail, you would be surprised at some of the things that you'll see. The jail, of course, has been here since 1904, and it served about 70 years until they moved the county seat in 1971 to Bolivia. So the jail sat empty for years until the Historic Society took it as a project to restore the jail, and they've done an excellent job. So I would encourage you to stop by and see a lot of the things that are here. If these graffiti field walls could talk, you would hear stories such as a time when they had the Great Escape. I was told that if you look outside, you'll actually see the area where they chiseled a hole through the wall, and they said two inmates kicked through the wall and had created bed sheets that they tied together, just like you would see in the movies, and shimmy down the bed sheets, ran across through the cemetery and through the woods to escape, and they were caught later in the week. So those may be some of the stories that the graffiti may tell you. Also, you would hear stories such as when city goers and kids, I was told they would walk by here routinely. It was fun for the kids They said their parents would tell them not to speak to the inmates, but they would yell from the second story bar covered windows to call my mom or bring me some food or get us some help in here. And they would laugh and run off. And they said they enjoyed doing that. They would come by citizens as well to try to communicate with the inmates. You also might hear a time when the sheriff had to call for help here at the jail back during the civil rights movement. They had a crowd of protesters here that were rioting, and an all call was given for help. Even the fire department came to help at the time. So there's a lot of things these walls could tell you. It's interesting to walk through. You actually see some of the graffiti. It's still on the walls. It was maintained, and you actually see some of the drawings. Quite good artists, I'm told, if you look at some of the things I've seen. They did a good job. So you would hear quite neat stories such as that. So again, I would encourage you, if you're in Southport, it's exciting to see. We have a lot of people who live in Southport, like myself, born and raised here. I was excited when they opened the jail to come in and see these things. So I would just encourage you to come by and visit the jail and take a look if you're in Southport. So if there's anything we can do for you at the police department, we're open 24/7. And again, my name is Chief Coring, and thank you for hearing our story.